The greatest act of charity that can be done for the poor souls in purgatory is to pray the Requiem Aeternam prayer, the eternal rest prayer. And I would go so far as to say it may be the greatest act of charity done overall, for these poor souls can do absolutely nothing to help themselves. Greetings, listeners of Latin Prayer Podcast, and welcome back for another episode. First, I want to extend my thanks to all of you who are listening to the podcast, especially those of you who are praying the Rosary daily. Don't forget to check the show notes for the daily Rosary links, and please share this podcast with your friends and families. Remember that Pope St. Pius X once said, if there were 1 million families praying the Rosary every day, the entire world would be saved. If you're listening on YouTube, Spotify, or iTunes, please hit the like button and leave a comment to show your support. It's your engagement with the podcast that helps it grow and succeed. Of course, if you've got any questions or suggestions for future episodes, don't hesitate to reach out to me via email at latinprayerpodcast@gmail.com. And lastly, if you would like to support this podcast further, please consider becoming a subscriber on my Patreon page. I have 4 tiers available to choose from. However, for a minimum monthly donation of only $1 to $2, you can help me continue to create content for you. Remember to support what you love, or else it goes away. Before we end today's episode, we will pray for our wonderful patrons, their families, and their intentions. So thanks again for tuning in. Let's get started with learning the Requiem Aeternam prayer in Latin. Now, this prayer is very straightforward. The Latin is super simple to understand, and it translates over into the English very easily. So we'll just take it bit by bit from the beginning. We'll work through it. This is one of the easiest prayers to memorize and to learn in Latin. It begins with the words, Requiem Aeternam, dona eis Domine. So the word requiem means to rest. Requiem should make you think of rest. So Requiem Aeternam is eternal rest. Requiem Aeternam, eternal rest. Dona eis Domine. So dona means to give. Think of the word to donate, right? So dona eis Domine. Eis is to them. So dona eis is give to them, and Domine is Lord. So when we put that together, we have eternal rest, give to them, O Lord. Requiem aeternam, dona eis Domine. It continues on, et lux perpetua luceat eis. The word lux should make you think of light. So et lux perpetua, perpetua should make you think of perpetual. So et lux perpetua is and the eternal light. Now, how do we say to shine? The word is luceat. So when we say luceat eis, we're saying shine on them. Et lux perpetua, and the eternal light, luceat eis, shine upon them. So we have requiem aeternam, dona eis Domine, eternal rest give to them, O Lord, and et lux perpetua luceat eis, light eternal, shine on them. And then the final line is Fidelium animae per misericordiam Dei requiescant in pace. So let's take the first one. Fidelium animae. So fidelium should make you think of fidelity or faithful. Animae is souls. So anima Christi, the soul of Christ, animae. So Fidelium animae means all the faithful souls. Per misericordiam Dei. So per misericordiam is by the mercy, and Dei is God. So by the mercy of God. Fidelium animae, may all the souls, by the mercy of God, per misericordiam Dei, requiescant in pace. And so requiescant should make you think of the first word, the requiem, the eternal rest, right? So requiescant is to rest, in pace is peace. And that's how we get, and may all the souls of all the faithful departed, through the mercy of God, rest in peace. Requiem aeternam, eternal rest, dona eis, give to them, Domine, O Lord, et lux perpetua, and the light eternal, luceat eis, shine upon them. Fidelium animae, for all the faithful souls, per misericordiam Dei, by the mercy of God, requiescant in pace, rest in peace. Amen. The Requiem Aeternam is a powerful prayer with a long history in the Church. It originated in the Middle Ages as a way to express grief and to seek God's mercy for the souls of the deceased. This prayer is an essential part of the Requiem Mass, which is a special Mass in the traditional rite that is held for the dead in the Roman Catholic Church. The beginning of this Mass starts with the Dies Irae, which is the Day of Wrath, and that's the first thing that's read. If you've never read this, I encourage you to do so because it vividly describes the final judgment. Now, right after this, the Requiem Aeternam is sung as a heartfelt plea for the eternal rest and peace for the departed soul. Famous composers like Mozart and Verdi have set this prayer to beautiful music, making it even more meaningful for people throughout the ages. It also holds a deep spiritual significance for us Catholics because it very clearly articulates our belief in the communion of saints, the idea that the Church is a connected community that includes both the living and the dead. By praying this prayer daily, we can show our love and compassion for those who have passed away. I said at the beginning, this may be the greatest act of charity that one can perform for the souls in purgatory. This prayer is heavily indulgenced, both prior to Vatican II and the changes and the reforms that took place in the Church and after. So that means that when we pray this prayer with sincerity and devotion, not only are we receiving spiritual benefits, but we are offering those spiritual benefits, and we can obtain the remission of temporal punishment due to sin, which of course then helps the souls on their path to heaven. For remember, once they are in this purgative state, this state of purification after death, they can do absolutely nothing to help themselves. They rely on us, the prayers and intercessions of the living, to assist them in reaching heaven. Praying the Requiem for these souls is an act of mercy and compassion. We can also go a step further and think about this in our own journey in preparation for eternity. The Requiem serves as a reminder to all of us, the living, to prepare for our own afterlife. It encourages us to be humble, to have gratitude for the blessings that God has given us and bestowed upon us, and of course, repentance, and prompting us to amend our lives, to fix whatever needs fixing, so that we can also attain salvation. If you are not already praying this prayer every day, I would encourage you to begin that practice. And if you are praying this prayer every day, make sure you do it more than just once throughout the day. Every time you think of a loved one that has passed, you think about your grandparents or your great-grandparents, you think about your family history, pray for them. Pray, pray, pray for them. Offer this for them. I want to leave you with this quote from Venerable Fulton Sheen. Quote, "As we enter heaven, we will see them, so many of them coming towards us and thanking us. We will ask who they are, and they will say, 'A poor soul that you prayed for in purgatory.'" End quote. So join me once again in praying for all the poor souls in purgatory. In nomine Patris et Filii et Spiritus Sancti. Amen. Requiem aeternam dona eis, Domine, et lux perpetua luceat eis, Fidelium animae per misericordiam Dei, requiescant in pace. Amen. In nomine Patris et Filii et Spiritus Sancti. Amen. I want to thank you again for tuning in to another episode. As always, I would like to finish our episode by praying for our wonderful patrons, for their family members, and their intentions. In nomine Patris et Filii et Spiritus Sancti. Amen. Pater noster, qui es in celi, sanctificetur nomen tuum, adveniat regnum tuum fiat voluntas tua, sicut in cielo et in terra. Panem nostrum quotidianum da nobis hodie, et dimite nobis debita nostra, sicut et nos dimitimus debitoribus nostris, et ne nos inducas in tentationem, sed libera nos a malo. Amen. Ave Maria, gratia plena, Dominus tecum, benedicta tu in mulieribus et benedictus fructus ventris tui, Iesus. Sancta Maria, Mater Dei, ora pro nobis peccatoribus, nunc et in hora mortis nostrae. Amen. Gloria Patri et Filio et Spiritui Sancto, sicut erat in principio et nunc et semper et in saecula saeculorum. Amen. In nomine Patris et Filii et Spiritus Sancti. Amen. So until our next episode, may God love you and Our Lady keep you.